In this video, we will teach you how to use a hemocytometer to estimate the population density in your algae culture.
In order to count your algae cells with a hemocytometer, you will need the following items. You will need your cell sample to the correct dilution. In order to determine your correct dilution, please click on the following link. A microscope with at least 600 times magnification. Disposable hemocytometer. Iodine tincture. This is made by adding 0.25 grams of iodine crystals to 100 milliliters of 95% ethanol. It must be kept in a sealable container and protected from light. We use foil to protect ours. Even with these precautions, our iodine tincture will only last for about 90 days. Kim wipes or paper towels. These are to protect your hemocytometer. While the slides are strong enough to sit on coarse materials like these, setting them on the bench may scratch or dirty them. Gloves. A vortexer. One 500 microliter pipette and one 10 microliter pipette with appropriate tips. If you are unfamiliar with how to use a pipette, click on the link for a refresher. One 2 milliliter centrifuge tube, deionized water, and compressed air. Now that you have your supplies, you're ready to begin. Start by putting on your gloves. Once your gloves are on, retrieve your hemocytometer. Unwrap it and place it on your Kim wipe. Next, shake your sample flask vigorously. This must be done to ensure the sample you take accurately represents your population density. Using the larger pipette, extract 500 microliters of your cell culture. Remember, always use a fresh pipette tip and always hold your pipette upright. Failure to do so may cause the sample to soak into your pipette, both ruining your experiment and contaminating future samples. Add your sample to the 2 milliliter microcentrifuge tube. Then eject your tip into the trash. Add one drop of iodine tincture to your sample. Now close your sample tube and vortex it for a couple of seconds to mix the iodine into your culture. Iodine kills and stains the cells so that they're easy to count. Now that we've mixed our iodine into our sample, we need to remove the cells that are stuck to the sides of the centrifuge tube. We do this by scraping the sides of the microcentrifuge tube while quickly pipetting up and down. This scrapes the cells off of the wall and the pipetting blows them off the pipette tip. Without this step, our count will be inaccurately low. Do not rush this step. Using the smaller pipetter, with a fresh tip, extract 10 microliters of your stained and mixed sample from the microcentrifuge tube. Pipette this volume into the hemocytometer's loading zone. Capillary action should take the sample into the counting chamber immediately. If it fails to take up the sample, or if you see dry spots, your counting chamber may be dirty. If this is the case, simply extract another 10 microliters and use the other counting chamber. Now that your sample is loaded, you can begin counting. Here's a diagram of the counting chamber of a hemocytometer. Note the varying sizes of each square. Any of these squares can be used to count your sample. If you have a large number of cells, you will want to pick a smaller square, or if you have a very small number of cells, you want to pick a very large square. If we don't do this, we will artificially inflate our count. This is an actual hemocytometer with our cell sample. First, we find a large top left square. Now that we have found the top left square, we will move to the right and down to find the center square. Given the high cell density in this sample, we will want to use the smaller squares for counting. It is important to count squares that are randomly spread across the counting area. You will want to choose 10 to 15 squares at random and count the cells contained within them. It is okay if there are no cells in the square you picked, so long as you picked each square randomly. If there are cells on the line of a square, do count those on the top and right lines, such as these. And do not count those on the bottom and left lines, such as those. We do this to avoid counting the same cell multiple times. Make sure to record your results in your lab notebook. We'll come back to them in a moment. If you want to increase the precision of your results, perform this entire procedure again on the same sample. 3 to 5 times is recommended. Taking the average of these counts will give you a better approximation of your cell density. Right now, we need to clean our hemocytometer. While these slides are disposable, cleaning them for reuse is very simple. Place the nozzle of your compressed air can into the overflow space of the hemocytometer. Now eject the sample by spraying the compressed air. Next, rinse the counting chamber by squirting deionized water into the loading zone. Using the compressed air, clear the sample chamber again. Repeat this process 2 more times and set your hemocytometer to dry on a paper towel.
You can now use this data to chart your growth rate, decide when to harvest, or in our next experiment, determine the lipid content of your algae culture.